let's speedrun Shandalar. In this video, I'm probably not going to establish a world record. My personal best is around 16 minutes, which is still a couple minutes short of the actual record. But my main goal is to just showcase a strategy, provide some entertaining commentary, and show you how to finish Shandalar from start to finish as quickly as possible, within hopefully around 20 minutes or so. Let's start a new game, easiest difficulty level, red as our starting color, the portrait doesn't really matter, and my name is still Frank, but let's turn it into Frank the Tank for this run. Okay, so once I hit enter, the timer is going to start. You won't be able to see the timer on the recording because Shandalar has to run full screen, but I can give you the total time near the end of the run. So 3, 2, 1, go. Okay, first thing is to go into a name town because there the cards sell for a little more. And we just sell off all of our artifacts, all of our creatures, and some of the unplayable enchantments. The reason for doing that is twofold. First of all, just get a bunch of cash. It's always nice. For example, I can buy some food so I can live. Never mind. The other... Gonna evade all of the random fights. The other reason for selling off all of these things is so I can eventually end up with a deck that only contains Shivan Dragon as an artifact or a creature, so that I always get it with the dice in the castles. That's the entire strategy behind this this run. Now to find a Shivan Dragon, I have to hit a hut, one of these maybe, with either a diamond mine where you can trade in amulets for cards, or a Nomad's Bazaar where you can trade gold for cards. And once I hit those, I can just trade in my stuff for a Shivan Dragon, and then I just head to the castles immediately and hope to beat the evil wizards there with my Shivan Dragon that I hopefully get off of some dice. So there's a lot of RNG in this run. Hey, there's the Nomad's Bazaar. We can buy the Shivan Dragon. Bing. Don't have anything else yet. Haven't. Oh, we found the green and the blue and the red castle, so I just head over there. I need to put the Shivan Dragon into my deck and sell some stuff so I can pay off the random monsters that harass me. Never mind. So I actually found this Shivan Dragon pretty quickly. I could not evade this fight, so I just have to concede here because my deck is incapable of beating anyone. I shouldn't actually walk through the forest, I should walk on the roads, that way it goes a bit faster. And let's enter a castle. Yes. So I'm on the easiest difficulty level, which means that there is typically not all that many enemies in the castles. And I just have to hope that I find the evil wizard quickly, well there he is, and find the dice that gives me a Shivan Dragon. Not many dice around here it seems. Come on. Well, without a Shivan Dragon I'm not going to beat anyone, especially not one of these evil wizards who starts with extra cards, and this is Lord of the Pit, I think. There's no dice. Okay, one last chance. There in the corner. Unlikely, but still artifact maybe. Okay. Well, no dice. I have to exit and reset. I mean, the castles are randomly generated every time you enter them. So just have to hope for a better layout this time. One that actually gives me a Shivan Dragon. So the entire strategy behind the run, I got the idea by watching a random stream of Derek Boyko, who is also sometimes speedrunning Shandalar. That seemed fun. So I also tried it. Well, I found the guy here, but I had to run into a new set of dice to get there. That way I lost the Shivan Dragon that I originally had, which is very bad news. Come on. Yes. Okay, so now we can beat the Green Wizard, kick him out of the castle. This battle is typically not going to be very difficult once I start with essentially a hasty Shivan Dragon in play. Can just kill this guy, so no acceleration for you. Giant Strength on here. You see these swamps in my deck as well. That's because I'm below the minimum deck size, which is I think 30 at this point. And then the game just fills up the deck with random basic lands. He gets a Killer Beast, which is a fine jump blocker. Waste some time. Not sure what was going on there, probably misclicked. You get 3 cards, definitely taking Taiga. Most of the green cards don't really sell for a lot. Force of Nature sell for something at least. Then onto the blue castle it is. But not before adding this to my deck. Selling the nonsense. Well, the white creature cannot actually follow me when I go into a swamp. Next castle. Yes. Hoping for a good layout again and to hit the Shivan Dragons. Step 1. Interesting. So I guess the bosses are always near the top left or top right corners. So I need to hit a Shivan in order to proceed. No, just reset. Try again. Maybe here. Well, I still need to hit a Shivan Dragon. Nope, that's not it. Come on, good dice. Nope. Maybe some good dice on the other side. This is quite a big castle. Let's see if there are some dice that I might be able to get later on. There is one set, so it's probably worth trying to go for this. Defeat the guy on the top left with my Shivan, then run back. Get the other dice, hopefully get a Shivan there, and then beat the evil blue wizard. That's the plan at least. Giant Strength on here. Yeah, Shivan Dragon is used to be. What? Wasting time for no reason at all? Like, let's troll the guy speedrunning the game. Well. Don't you dare cancel more of the Mishra's Factory. Yep, there she is. So now I have to get back, get this dice, and hope that it's a Shivan Dragon. One time. Yes, it is. So with this we should be able to beat the Blue Wizard. Currently just past the 8-minute mark. So far, so good. Just start. This is fine. Eternal Warrior is actually quite good against the Blue Mage, because they sometimes have unstable mutation on Zephyr Falcon, which makes it into a 4/4. This way, I can still block it. The other reason why Eternal Warrior is quite important is because they often play Stasis and then, tap down your creatures for a couple of turns. But my Shivan Dragon doesn't actually tap, so unaffected by Stasis. That can be quite important. Oh. Gambit. Well, he's dead on the next turn. Let's see, something like a twiddle or an unsummon. Nope. Got there, so I'm taking Volcanic Island, because that's actually useful. Psionic Blast sells for a lot, and well, random cards. So where to next? The Red Castle. Down, then to the left. Add this thing to my deck. Some more food. Okay. At the Red Castle, you didn't want to enter here, that hitbox. At the Red Castle, you actually get some useful cards for your deck, because you can select three red cards. So, after this castle, we should actually have a semi reasonable deck. Oh, we got the Sheevan. This is a strange layout. Well, let's go. Didn't actually have to take a mulligan. I was gonna win with the Sheevan Dragon anyway. It only wastes time. Wow. I mean, Shandalar sometimes does these really strange things. Giant Growth, the opponent's guys. But this is also a new high. I have to exit. Lightning Bolt, my own creature. It's just so I can gain a life with this artifact that all of them start the game with. Yeah, that's just completely ridiculous. On the other hand, it also adds to the appeal of the game in one way or another. Okay, so I have to beat this one and then get the Sheevan Dragon off of the next dice. Then I should have him. Boom. See, the games go fast this way, which is exactly what you want. Sheevan, yes. Okay. Now, I think the Red Wizard starts with a Brothers of Fire in play. That's a 2-2, so they might actually outrace you. But I found an emulation for it, which means that now I can just race. The only thing I have to watch out for is, I guess, a double Lightning Bolt on my Sheevan Dragon. That would be annoying. Every tower just wastes a lot of time. Looks like he doesn't have the double bolt. Mana Flare. I'll take it, I guess. Do I have Lethal here? I can add 6. No, not yet. Guess I'll add the Sheevan then. Okay, well, this should be lethal then. Okay. I'm gonna take a Sheevan Dragon. It's a backup one in case I lose one to empty. A Bolt, because that's a good card. I guess a Fireball as some more removal. See, now my deck is getting better. I need to find the black and the white castle. I still have a lot of exploring to do. So, let's improve my deck. So I have that here, some more food, and well, just explore a lot. Where it is smart to not walk into a forest or a swamp, because that just takes too long. Best to stay on the roads, there the walking speed is better. Ooh, I found a black castle, how lucky. Actually, this run is going quite well. Just hit the 13 minute mark, and this is the fourth castle already. This doesn't look to be a very good layout. Need some dice. Any dice? Nope. Now let's just exit. Try again. Yes, enter. I am absolutely brave enough. Especially when I get the Sheevan Dragon. Maybe here. Let's lure the pit. Yeah, this is not gonna work either. Yeah, as you can see, there's lots of RNG in this game. You have to be a bit lucky to get a reasonable layout. Power of 4. Yep. got some obscure cards. The troll, I think. So there's a lot of enemies here. But I'm hoping that I can get to the black boss after this. Should be possible. That's 7. Okay, yeah, there he is. And I got the Shivan Dragon. Excellent. This is going well. The black boss is sometimes somewhat difficult to beat, and I could actually just lose this game to the Carrion Ants. Okay, well, he doesn't pump it, that's fine. Will of the Wisp. I didn't have a stop at the end of the turn, of course. Like, he typically isn't going to keep up mana for the Will of the Wisp. So that's good for me. In the meantime, I'm also losing to the Carrion Ant, so I guess I have to kill this off. Well, that works. It was a bit risky, actually, what I did. I should have just fireballed the Will of the Wisp on a previous turn, because I could have lost to it in the long game. But the AI typically taps out anyway, they're not that smart. Sewers of Astark, while completely unplayable, sells for a lot, so might as well take that. And, well, I found the White Castle as well. Wow, that's actually a really good run. Yeah. Don't want... Come on. Okay, here, the White Castle. That should be the last one. And I'm currently going into the 16 minute mark. Come on, good layout. Shivan Dragon, excellent. Now let's go in here. Boom. Immolation. Oh, wait, that's still not enough. I cannot count. This place all over the place. Okay, well, this is still lethal. Well, there is the boss and the Shivan Dragon. So now, after finishing this one, I will have almost completed the game. Sweet, I was pretty lucky with the finding the castles. What I have to watch out for here in this game is Black Lotus. That's one thing. Fine. One thing to watch out for is like the banding ability of Mesa Pegasus, especially when he finds some kind of pro red guy. The other thing is balance. And actually I cannot attack anymore. I'm losing this race. Well, this sucks. And got protection from white, which doesn't really matter. Still cannot really attack here. I have to wait until I find my second Shivan Dragon. Now I can attack. Wasting lots of time with nonsense. Let's see. Only this. Oh. I misplayed. Should have attacked with both. That was lethal. I looked at this and I saw green. I thought it wouldn't be enough. But this is. Take the first three white cards that I see. Whatever, doesn't matter. Yes, done. Start, concede, because we don't have to actually beat him. And that's it. 18 minutes, 24 seconds. That's all it takes to beat this game of Shandalar. You don't actually have to beat the final boss. You can just concede immediately because the game still gives you this life is good screen. Shivan Dragon, that's the key to beating this game quickly. Well, I'm happy with the time. With some better execution and some better RNG, You can always do it in even fewer minutes, but well, 18 minutes and some seconds is good enough for this video. So I hope you enjoyed this. Hope I have shown you some of the joys of playing Shandalar, and see you next time.